Because 3 days ago we received a particular message to all of you from Rene Gonzalez, who's currently on parole in Florida, representing all the five themselves, and it's specifically to all of you attending this vigil tonight. Dear friends and supporters from the United Kingdom, once again you take your precious time to gather here in front of the building which represents the government that has kept us in prison to protect their self-given privilege of bringing death and terrorism to the people of Cuba. Once again, we have to take the opportunity to express to all of you our admiration and gratitude. It has been 14 years of hardship for us and for our families. It has been a calculated treatment designed not only to break our spirits, but also to shatter our ties with our loved ones, to undermine our most immediate and cherished base of moral support through the imposition of a forced geographical distance. But our captors never imagined that from more distant places, people like all of you here would come to the rescue with your solidarity and your sense of justice. Now we still have the unwavering love of our families, and we have something more than we never expected. The love of thousands of people all over the world, represented by you here. In the 14 years that has passed since our arrests, that support from all over the world has steadily grown. But it started with only a few personal messages, some of them from this country. It was like a small seed that grows into a big tree and then multiplies to become a forest. Nevertheless, even in the middle of such a big forest, we can still identify that beautiful tree growing in the United Kingdom, which started as just a small seed. We can identify it by its wide trunk, the well-developed branches, and more than anything, by its fruits of love, struggle, and solidarity. For all of it, again and forever, we send you our most sincere and deep feelings of admiration and gratitude. A big embrace to you all, Gerardo, Ramon, Antonio, Fernando, and René. Thank you. It's a real honour tonight to welcome our last speaker. We've spent the last couple of weeks with Aleida at the TUC, the Trades Union Congress, up in Scotland, in Nottingham, in Newcastle. She spoke to hundreds and hundreds of people, 500 in Glasgow, 400 in Newcastle. We had a room packed to overflowing last night in the House of Commons. And many of you I know will have seen the newspaper reports in The Observer, on the BBC, in the Daily Mirror, the Daily Record. She has moved many, many people on this particular visit, and it is a real privilege that she's with us here tonight to speak primarily about this campaign for justice for the Miami Five. Please give an extremely warm welcome to Aleida Guevara.
A todos y a todas.
Good evening, everybody.
Muchísimas gracias por estar aquí hoy.
Thank you for coming here tonight.
Hoy es un día que a mí me gustaría poder hablar inglés.
Today is a day where I would like to be able to speak in English.
Porque tendría muchas cosas que decirle al gobierno de Estados Unidos.
Because there's an awful lot of things I would like to say to the government of the United States.
Y me gustaría usar algunas palabritas fuertes en inglés.
And I'd like to use some strong language in English.
Pero como Luis es un caballero, no puedo abusar de él.
But because I am a gentleman, she doesn't want to abuse me.
Pero de todas maneras espero que me escuchen bien.
But I sincerely hope that they listen well.
Hay muchas cosas que tendría que exigirle al gobierno de Estados Unidos.
There's many things that I would have to demand of the government of the United States.
Nací en un país bloqueado, agredido por Estados Unidos.
I was born in a country blockaded and subject to aggression by the United States.
Pero también es cierto que nací en un país libre y soberano.
But it's also true that I was born in a free and sovereign country.
Y que no doblega su cabeza nunca más ante nadie.
A country that will never bow its head to anyone again.
Por eso es muy hermoso poder estar aquí hoy con ustedes.
That's why it's very good to be able to be with you here today.
Cada uno de ustedes representa lo mejor de su propio pueblo.
Each one of you represents what's best in your own people.
Y eso realmente me llena de orgullo poder compartirlo hoy.
And that's a real question of pride for me to be able to share this with you here today.
Y también créanme, el que ustedes estén aquí hoy nos da mucha fuerza a nosotros para seguir en la lucha.
And please note that the fact that you're here today gives us a lot of strength to continue in the struggle.
Cuando comenzó mi pueblo la lucha por la liberación de estos cinco hombres,
when my people started the campaign to free the five,
yo comencé como una mujer cubana más.
I participated as one more Cuban woman.
Pero poco a poco tuve el privilegio de ir conociendo a las madres, a las esposas, a los hijos.
But slowly I got to know the mothers, the wives, and their children.
Y ahora no lucho solo por la libertad de mis cinco hermanos.
And now I don't just struggle for the freedom of the five. My five brothers,
sino también por las madres que temen no poder abrazar nuevamente a sus hijos.
But also for the mothers who fear that they won't be able to embrace their sons again.
En la última visita que la mamá de Antonio le hizo a la cárcel hace apenas unos días.
And the last visit that Antonio's mother made to him in jail.
Ella le dijo: hijo, si pudiera guardarte en mi cartera, te llevaría conmigo.
Son, if I could put you in my purse, I would take you home with me.
Ya tiene 80 años.
She is 80 years old.
Y la vida pasa, sigue pasando.
And life goes on.
Y a pesar de toda nuestra fuerza, a pesar de toda la solidaridad, no conseguimos todavía justicia para esos cinco hombres.
And despite all our force, and despite all our strength, we have yet not gained justice for those five men.
Lucho ahora también por cinco mujeres extraordinarias.
I'm also struggling now for five extraordinary women.
Compañeras de sus hombres.
Comrades of their menfolk.
Realmente historias de amor que uno quisiera poder vivir.
Histories of love that one would want to live.
Y lucho precisamente para que ese amor no desfallezca y ellas puedan disfrutar de la vida junto al hombre que han amado siempre.
And quite frankly, I struggle so that they can have that love next to the men that they've always loved.
Pero lucho con más fuerza todavía.
I struggle with more strength.
Para que los hijos de estos hombres no tengan que sufrir lo mismo que sufrí yo.
So that the sons of these men don't have to suffer what I had to suffer.
A pesar del amor y del respeto que siento por mi padre.
Despite the love that I feel for my father.
Siempre he tenido la añoranza de estar junto a él, de poderlo abrazar, de poder besarlo.
I've always had the wish to be able to embrace my father, to kiss him.
Pero la vida no me lo permitió a mí.
But life didn't give me that right.
Sin embargo, ellos tienen todavía la posibilidad de compartir con sus hijos la propia vida.
Despite this, the five still have the option of being able to share their lives in the future with their children.
Por eso lucho con todas las fuerzas para que ellos vuelvan a sus hogares.
That's why I struggle with all the force I can muster so that they return home.
Y por eso no me canso de decirle al gobierno de Estados Unidos.
That's why I never tire of telling the government of the United States
que están corriendo un grave peligro.
That they're running a grave danger.
Porque la justicia en Estados Unidos trabaja con precedentes.
Because justice in the United States has got precedences.
Y la violación de la propia justicia de Estados Unidos es muy mal precedente.
And the violation of the very legal norms of the United States is a very bad precedent.
¿Hasta cuándo el gobierno de Estados Unidos va a mantener esta injusticia?
Until when is the government of the United States going to maintain this injustice?
Pero todavía más importante.
But still more important.
¿Hasta cuándo nosotros vamos a tolerar esa injusticia?
Until when are we going to tolerate this injustice?
Por eso es tan hermoso verlos aquí hoy.
That's why it's so wonderful to see you all here today.
Por eso es tan importante haber escuchado a todos los oradores que hoy compartieron esta tribuna.
That's why it was very important to hear all the speakers here on this tribune tonight.
Muchas gracias por esa solidaridad.
Thank you for your solidarity.
Muchas gracias por su resistencia.
Thank you for your resistance.
Pero todavía tenemos que hacer más.
But we still have to do more.
Tenemos que multiplicar nuestras fuerzas.
We need to multiply our force.
Decía José Martí.
José Martí stated.
Los malos triunfan cuando los buenos somos indolentes.
The bad ones triumph when the good ones sleep.
Rompamos el bloqueo de silencio que han impuesto sobre esta verdad.
Let's break the blockade of silence imposed on this truth.
Multipliquemos la información entre todos nosotros.
Let's multiply the information amongst all of us.
Cada persona que se una a esta lucha es una fuerza más para poder triunfar.
Every person who unites to this struggle is yet another person to triumph.
Hay una pequeña canción de América Latina.
There's a small song from Latin America.
Que dice.
That says.
Hermano, dame tu mano.
Brother, give me your hand.
Vamos juntos a buscar.
Let's go together to find.
Una cosa pequeñita.
A little thing.
Que se llama libertad.
Which is called freedom.
Busquemos esa libertad.
Let's find that freedom.
Encontremos nuestra libertad.
Let's find our freedom.
Es muy importante.
It's very important.
Mantener la unidad.
It's very important to maintain unity.
Esta canción dice también.
This song also says.
Métale a la marcha, métale al tambor, métale que traigo un pueblo en mi voz.
Oh God. I'll put it into the march, put it into the drum, I bring a people in my voice.
Métale a la marcha, métale al tambor, métale que traigo un pueblo en mi voz. Métale a la marcha, métale al tambor, métale que viene la revolución. Muchas gracias.
Thank you.